There's somebody you should place honor. Especially those God has put over you. Those that the Lord has put over us as fathers. And somebody said one time, I don't need a father. I don't need a spiritual father. Jesus is my father. I was just laughing. You can see that he's a young boy. He doesn't know anything. He said, I don't need a spiritual father. What do I need it for? Jesus said, call no man father. Call no man father on the earth. Call no man father on the earth. I don't need a father. Jesus my father. I was just looking at him. I said, oh. You know, when a person is confused, you know, and it's a terrible thing. When the confusion is not powered by Lucifer, it makes it worse. You must have somebody you are accountable to. You must have somebody you are submitting to. You must have somebody you are preferring in a place of honor. Affectionate, that means with all your heart. I honor this man. This is my father in the faith. It is not everybody that should be your father. Let me even go into that one. It's not everybody. That the man is preaching or he has big church does not mean he should be your father. Do you understand what I'm saying? It's not. Who should be your father is very clear. In 1 Corinthians, put ESV translation. 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 19. In 1 Corinthians 4, 19. Look at it. 1 Corinthians chapter 4, somewhere in verse 15. Leave verse 19. Verse 15. 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 15. Look at it. Okay, it's not here. 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 15. Okay, everybody, look at it. He said, for though you have countless who? Guides. Advisors. Counselors. Instructors. Are you seeing it? The five steps of how to become successful in ministry. That's an instructor that is talking. He said, there are so many of them. He said, you do not have many fathers. There are very few people who are fathers. So how do you know who is a father? He said, for I became your father in Christ Jesus. How? Through the gospel. It is the man that brings you the gospel of Jesus Christ. Or that preaches the gospel of Christ. Who is placed as a father over anybody. This is how a man becomes and in a person's father. This is, look, it's very clear. I became a father to you through the gospel. Not because you became our church member. I don't know whether I'm making sense to somebody here. A lot of people think because they are the church member of a church, and you know, the man is my father. Wrong. It's not scriptural. Or I belong to this association, so the man is my father. Or the man has a big property, has money. No. I became. There's a becoming over an individual by the gospel. He said, therefore, because I have become, for you, I'm not a guide, an instructor. He said, because I have become. Look at the next verse, verse 16. Look at what it says. Put verse 16. God punish ignorant. Look at verse 16. He said, I urge you then, be, imitate me. A guide, an instructor will never tell you to imitate him. Go and prove your ministry. Yes. That's what an instructor says. Do what I say, but don't do what I do. That's an instructor. If he becomes a father to you in the gospel, he will urge you to imitate him. Because his life is the gospel. The gospel will naturally become your own life. But I'm the branch pastor of So-So Church. It doesn't mean the president and founder is your spiritual father. He's an instructor. There were some people that Paul met that were born again Christians already. He met them Christians. Where he met them how? Christians, including Timothy. He met Christians already in Timothy. Christian, Timothy was not a Muslim. But when he met Timothy, like he said in Church of Galatia, he said, I travel again until Christ was formed in thee. That's how I gave birth to you people. That's how I became the father of Timothy. I traveled again until Christ was formed in thee. Are you seeing this thing? So, to honor a father is to be a follower of the father. It must be somebody you are following. The person you are following must be a father. The person that is a father to you, that you are honoring, is the one you must follow. You know, some people say, I don't follow man. I don't follow man. I follow Christ. Get out of town. I don't know where all these people get all this from. You know, especially when a pastor says that. How can you, a pastor, say that? You know, I don't understand that a pastor will open man and say, me, I'm not following somebody. Everybody is following somebody. Whether consciously or unconsciously. Whether directly or indirectly. There is nobody that is not following somebody. If you are not following by wisdom, you are following by stupidity. There's no middle ground. Somebody is following somebody. Whether the right way, through the door or behind the door, somehow, somebody is following somebody. There's a following. But Paul categorically said in 1 Corinthians 11:1, he said, put it, 1 Corinthians 11:1, put King James. 1 Corinthians 11:1. Look at it. Be ye what? Followers of me. Even as I. Who am I following? I follow Christ. See, that's how you know a spiritual father. He must, because what he will transfer to you is the gospel. Not how to do church program. A lot of people have not met their spiritual father yet. They have not. Bless you. Thank you. Thank you. A lot of people have not. They have not met a spiritual father yet. When you meet a spiritual father, Jesus will come alive in your heart. He said, because I follow Christ. So as you are following me, who are you following? Christ. Not how to build branches, church branch. Of course, there's nothing wrong with you too. The primary assignment is to follow Christ. It's not to start branches. It's not even to start a church. Am I making sense? Because the reason you are we are born again is for the fellowship of the Son of God. 1 Corinthians 1:9, that's what he said. He said, God is faithful who had called us to the fellowship of his Son. The koinonium, the intermingling, the intimacy of his Son. God is faithful by whom you were called. And look at what the calling is for. Unto the fellowship of his Son, Jesus Christ. So John now said in 1 John chapter 1, in verse number 3. Look at what John, from verse 3. 1 John chapter 1 from verse 3. He said, that which we have seen and have heard, declared we unto you, that you also may have fellowship with us. Truly our fellowship is with the Father. And who? With the Son. This is our calling. If you are not following a man who is presenting fellowship in Christ to you, he is not a father. He's an instructor. Who is he now? He's an instructor.